welcome to another episode of Neutral. Today, we're high atop the Ferris wheel here at the Royal Easter Show. We've been invited down by the guys from Isuzu Team D-Max to hang out with them and check out their awesome stunt show. Last year on the show, I reviewed an Isuzu D-Max. A couple of weeks after the show, I got a phone call from a couple of guys telling me I did a few things wrong. So here we are a few months later in Sydney at the Royal Easter Show, and these guys are gonna show me what I did wrong. It's Team D-Max, the awesome stunt show. How are you?
Fantastic, how are you?
I'm well. Nice to meet you.
Yeah, nice to meet you.
So tell me a little bit, we've all been to the show as kids. We've grown up watching the stunt show. How long have you guys been around?
Look, this is our first year in the Isuzu D-Maxes, but the Precision Drive team has existed since the late 60s and started in VWs and has been through a number of manufacturers, and this is the second manufacturer that I've been involved with, but I think over all of the years there's been about 40 odd drivers throughout the whole history of the Precision Drive team, and look, I think it's just a standard thing that people love to see. Obviously at the Royal Easter Show here in Sydney. So there's four full-time drivers, Jack Monkhouse, Dave Shannon, myself, and Michael Long. So Long is actually the rookie this year. So he's a first-timer. So he's still adjusting and getting used to it. But look, you wouldn't get into the team unless you had a lot of experience. And these things, there's not a huge amount of mods to them. They're a turbo diesel, rear-wheel drive, dual cab, and still road registered.
Fantastic. So they're almost what you would buy off the showroom floor, but with just a few modifications.
Absolutely. I suppose the flashiest thing is the stickers and all of the Isuzu and Bridgestone livery all over the vehicles. But we've just given the cars a little bit of a tweak in the tune department. You know, you can do that. And the electronics these days, we've changed the suspension, so they've got Bilstein shock absorbers in it. We've actually put a lock diff in the rear. And because they're a turbo diesel, obviously they're not the loudest vehicle out there. So I think we're on evolution 10 on the exhaust system at the moment, just trying to get some sort of noise.
All right, so obviously, so when I was growing up and going to the show, it's the same team. So you've progressed through and you're in these vehicles now.
Yep.
How many shows do you do a year?
Oh, look, we do probably 25 to 30 shows a year. But to give people an idea, like the Sydney Royal Easter Show is just one of those shows. So it normally equates to about 100 to 120 days of performing, and we do probably two or three shows per day on average. So here at the Royal Easter Show, we're doing two shows a day, one at lunch and one in the evening. So, you know, we get a fair bit of seat time, but a lot of people don't realise, you know, some of us live in different states. The cars could be anywhere around Australia on their way home from a show, on their way to a show, on display at an Isuzu dealer. So we don't do any practice. So we're just expected to rock up for the show. And all of our shows are different from arena to arena. So we don't do the same show twice at, you know, from one show to the other.
So if you make a mistake, it's going to be in front of a live audience.
Oh, absolutely. And that's what, you know, people sometimes, I think they enjoy seeing as well. So, you know, there's a little bit of pressure on us, obviously with all of our moves. And, you know, some of the cars have got little, you know, marks on them. So we certainly do get close. And obviously there's a lot of variables out there as well. It's not just the speed, but because, you know, we're a team that drives 99.9% of the time on dirt or mud or grass. And so the conditions or the grip level can vary so much. You know, one car on the inside can be on a dry piece of dirt and I might be on the outside in the mud. So I've got half the grip level, and we all have to allow for that because there's always a little bit of movement, always a little slip and sliding. So you try not to crash into each other, especially when you're millimetres apart from one another.
Cool. So have you ever hit a wall?
Oh, I'm not going to say that I haven't.
I'm sure the other guys will dub you in.
Yeah, absolutely. Look, I think we've all been guilty of touching a wall, and that's just part of it.
So it sounds like these guys have got a bit of a challenging time out there on the track, but I guess the great thing for the people sitting in the audience is those close shaves sometimes do make contact and makes it all that more spectacular.
That's right. And, you know, one of the other things, I suppose, the tyres, a lot of people think they're probably on a specialist tyre and they're a two-wheel drive vehicle on a standard Bridgestone tyre, and that's why Bridgestone loves supporting us. They're a normal tyre that you'd, you know, buy in a normal family vehicle and drive out there on the street. So the only thing that we change in any of the cars is the two-wheeling car. We just put a little bit more air pressure in the two-wheeling car, just so when it's at an angle, it actually doesn't pull the tyre from the bead of the wheel.
Excellent. Right, and I've heard that you've got something lined up for me today.
I think so. I think we actually might have a spare spot in the passenger seat. So that little test that you were talking about, I think we should take you for a wrap to see what you can see an Isuzu D-Max can really do.
Awesome. I can't wait.
Fantastic. Look forward to taking you around.
Awesome. Can't wait for that. Let's go suit up and jump in the car.
Awesome. What we're going to do is pop you in the two-wheeling car with our legendary Dave Shannon, and just happens to be Dave Shannon is standing to your left.
G'day, Dave.
Hi, Dave. Good.
Nice to meet you.
Welcome to our office, mate.
Fantastic.
Safety first. We'll get that helmet on and a harness.
Yeah, I don't like to fall out.
There we go.
So that's it, so we literally just sit here, you jump in and we go to a few laps.
Let's go.
All right. So here we are, we're sitting in the tunnel at the moment, only seconds to go before we head out on the field. Can't wait. There you go, the announcer just called us out. We're going head to head with the other guys coming in the opposite direction. There's a great crowd out here at the Easter show, and I tell you what, I'm living a boyhood fantasy of driving around with these stunt guys in front of a massive crowd. Absolute thrill. Change formation. This time we're going two by two, nose to nose. Obviously we don't condone tailgating, but technically this isn't tailgating. This is nose to nose and there's only inches between these two cars. I've never driven at speed with the car in front of me driving at reverse, me looking at the driver. We've just moved into the reverse diamond position now, which we've got one car out the front. He's driving in reverse, the two of us side by side, and then we've got a car at the rear making up that diamond formation. Great to see when you look out in the crowd, there's so many young kids standing on the fences. I remember doing the exact same thing when I was 8 or 9. We change formation again and we kick it up another gear. So the boys have told me I've got to take notes, because last year when I did the Isuzu D-Max story, I got a few things wrong. Apparently I didn't have it sideways enough and I never got it up on two wheels. So they're going to show me how to do it right. Running a slightly modified format today because there's some equestrian events set up out in the middle here, so they're limited to the outside of the track. So slightly modified program, but I tell you what, from where I'm sitting, it's still a hell of a lot of fun, and looking at the faces of the kids just there on that wall, they're enjoying it too. Okay, so we've just come onto the grass area now. This is cue the ballet. It looks like precision from the outside in the grandstand. I tell you what, from in here, looks just as good. Now this is more my pace. This is probably more the speed of what I did in my review. So I've obviously learned today that what I've got to do is got to crank up the speed, push these turbo diesels to their limit, use a lot more handbrake, and spend a little bit more time looking out my side mirror as I'm driving down the road sideways. We're about to do the two-wheel manoeuvre. Dave's got to concentrate hard, so I'm going to shut up and hold on. Managed to do a full lap. The camera took a pounding on landing, but the crowd enjoyed it, and I tell you, the view from in here, I've never had to sit in a car before and actually look down on the driver. That's incredible stuff. All right, so just to find it out, handbrake, a little bit more precision, and precisely back into the tunnel. Well, thanks very much for that. That was an incredible drive.
My pleasure.
What a drive. Dave, thanks so much for having me in the car today. That's a childhood dream come true. And that lap on two wheels was totally spectacular. Thanks very much again for your time.
I'm glad you enjoyed it, Jason. It was a pleasure to have you. I'll just make you aware that that waiver form you signed earlier on also entitled to the one free car wash.
Oh, brilliant.
And you're the washer and this is the car.
Okay, that doesn't sound too good. But I guess at the end of the day, if I got to ride in that with these guys, what's washing a car? See you next time.